Hi guys, Greg here from TATV, and today we're going to take a look at the Hornady Cam Lock Bullet Puller. If you've ever missed a step when reloading a bunch of cartridges, you already know how frustrating it can be to have to toss out a bunch of expensive ammunition components, particularly when you get into the larger, harder to find calibers. Fortunately, if you want to try and fix your mistake, you're not without options. Hornady's Cam Lock Bullet Puller is one such option. The unit itself consists of four pieces: the body, the cam lock assembly, the plunger, and one or more collets, which are caliber specific. Just a quick note here, the collets are not included with the puller, so if you decide to buy one of these, don't forget to order collets. The bullet puller works by exerting downward pressure when the handle is pulled. This in turn forces the plunger down, which in turn causes the pedals on one of the collets to squeeze together, gripping the bullet. When the handle is raised again, the pressure dissipates and the collet releases the bullet. Let's take a look at how it's used. Okay, so first we'll remove the cam lock from the body and take the plunger out. With that done, we'll swap out the collet with the correct model for the caliber that we're pulling, in this case, a 38 Special. Now that we've got that out of the way, we'll replace the plunger, thread the cam lock back into place, and we're all ready to install our puller into a single stage press. Insert a cartridge into the shell plate of your press and raise the ram so that the bullet is inside the bullet puller while the case remains outside. It's very important to try to line this up properly the first time or you'll risk damaging the cartridge casing. Now begin turning the cam lock until you feel it contact the bullet, and we don't want a lot of force here, we just want to feel it touch. Gently pull the cam lock handle down. When you're tightening it, you'll start to feel it grip more forcefully on the bullet. It's important to go slowly at first as we're trying to feel how much tension or force is on the bullet. Too little and the collet will lose its grip. Too much and the collet pedals could break. Finally, we'll lower the ram and voila, the bullet is pulled from the cartridge. Once you've got the settings dialed in properly, you can go ahead and pull dozens of bullets very quickly without having to adjust the puller again. While Hornady's puller does work pretty well overall, there are some limitations you should be aware of. The first is a problem most collet-style bullet pullers have, and that's that it doesn't do very well with cast bullets. Even hard cast lead bullets tend to get marred and deformed by the puller. The second problem is one you'll find a lot of people talking about online, and that's the very poor design of the 45 caliber collets. While the smaller caliber collets work great, the 45's larger diameter means the collet pedals are extremely thin. Although Hornady's generally good about replacing them, it's really frustrating to have one break on you after only a few uses. If you're a diehard Hornady fan and don't reload large diameter cartridges, that's one thing. But if you're a fan of the 45, you may want to steer clear of Hornady's offering until they come out with a better collet design.